Hello students, welcome back to one more video on calculus. So we will start our last chapter, continuity. Continuity. So the first definition in this chapter is continuous function. Definition of continuous function. Continuous function. So the function is said to be continuous. You will see the first of all, we'll write the definition. Let A be a subset of R, and suppose f from that A to R be a function, and C belongs to A, C be any element of A. As we have seen in the previous chapter, C was our cluster point. Similarly, here, like here, C belongs to A is one element. We say that this function is continuous. We say that f is continuous at C, f is continuous at C, that is function is said to be continuous on some element of domain A, that is C is the element of A. So function f is said to be continuous at C if for given any epsilon positive. Similarly, like previous chapter, we will use the epsilon delta definition here. If given epsilon positive, there exists some delta positive such that if suppose x is any point of A, is any point of A satisfying mod of x minus c less than delta, that is x is any point which is very close to c, that is x minus c less than delta means x is element which is in delta neighborhood of c, then mod of f of x, image of this x, mod of f of x minus image of this c, f of x minus f of c is less than epsilon. The function f is said to be continuous if for given epsilon positive, that is if suppose f is function from a set A to suppose set of real numbers, then for that set A there exists one element C for which suppose x are the elements which are very close to that C, that is x are in the delta neighborhood of C, then here f of x minus f of c is less than delta. So if we apply the function on given domain and if we find there are some elements f of x which are very close to c, which are very close to f of c, that is this f of x are in epsilon neighborhood of f of c, then for that case we have some delta neighborhood around c for which x lies inside that neighborhood. That is, this is the definition of continuous function. Function f is said to be continuous if for given epsilon positive there exists some delta positive, if for given epsilon positive there exists some delta positive such that x is any point of A which is very close to c, that is x mod x minus c is less than delta, then mod of f of x minus f of c is less than epsilon. This is whenever we say that given function is continuous. Now if the function is fails to be continuous at that point C, the function is said to be discontinuous at that point. We will write one note here. If that function f fails to be continuous at that point C, then we say that f is discontinuous, at that point C. If function fails to be continuous, then we say that function is discontinuous at that point. Now we will see one remark on continuity. So if C belongs to A, C is the cluster point of A, right? Suppose be a cluster point of A, then then we say that f is continuous at point C, then we say that f is continuous at C if and only if the following three conditions are hold. That is, the first condition is that is if and only if limit x tends to C f of x is equals to f of C. We say that function f is continuous if and only if limit x tends to C f of x is equals to f of C. That is, there is a little bit difference between existence of limit and continuity. Limit, whenever we say that limit exists, if right and left and limits are equal, then we say that limit exists. But if we say that, whenever we say that the function is continuous, function is said to be continuous if left hand limit exists, which is equals to right hand limit. Left and right hand limit exist, means limit of given function exists, and that limit is equals to value of the function at point C, then function is said to be continuous. So there is a little bit difference. So suppose first condition is C is cluster point, then this limit exists, then we say that the following condition are holds. Suppose thus if C is cluster point of A, then three conditions must hold for F, hold for F to be continuous at C. Function is, when we say that function is continuous, whenever the following three conditions holds. That is, the following three conditions are mandatory to function to be a continuous function. So first condition is F must be defined at C. Function value of F must be defined at C. That is, F of C exists. This is the first condition. Now the second condition is the limit of f at c must exist in R, in real line. We are dealing in real line, so in this whole paper we are not exceeding set of real numbers, so limit must exist at some point R. At some point of R, that is, the first condition is f of c must exist. Second condition is limit of that function must exist in real numbers. And third condition, both these two are equal. These two values, that is, the value of f at c, that is f of c, is equals to value of limit must be same. The two values must be equal. The two values must be equal. So these three conditions holds, then we say that function is continuous. If the only second condition holds, then we say that limit exists, and the limit exists and is limit is equals to f of c, then we say that the function is continuous. So this is the definition of continuous function. Now we will see the sequential criteria for continuity. That is, like previous chapter we have seen the sequential criteria for limits. Now here we will see the sequential criteria for continuity. Sequential criteria for continuity. Sequential criteria for continuity. First of all, we will take one definition. A function f from A to R is continuous at point, suppose C belongs to A, if and only if for every sequence, if and only for every sequence, suppose xn, if and only for every sequence in A that converges to some element C, that converges to C, the sequence f of xn, that is the image of this sequence f of xn, converges to image of this C, converges to f of C. Function f from A to R is said to be continuous at point C in A if and only if for every sequence in xn, if and only if for every sequence xn in A that converges to C. For a cluster point of given set A, if there exists some sequence which converges to C, then image of that sequence must converge to image of this point C, then given function is continuous. This is the definition of continuous function. Sorry, this is the sequential criteria for continuous function. Now, the next is discontinuity criteria. Next one is discontinuity criteria. Again, let A be a subset of R and f from that set A to R be function and C be any point of A. Then that function f is discontinuous. Discontinuous at that point C if and only if there exists a sequence in A, suppose again that sequence will be xn in A that converges to C, such that this xn converges to C, but image of this xn does not converge to f of C, but the sequence f of xn does not converge to f of C. This is the contrary definition which we have seen in the continuity, that is which is completely different. So, completely opposite. We have seen the sequential criteria for continuity, that is if in domain some sequence converges to C, then image of that sequence converges to image of this C, then we function say that continuous. Now here discontinuous, function is said to be discontinuous if for C there exists some sequence in A which converges to C, but image of that sequence xn, that is f of xn, does not converge to f of C, then we say that given function is discontinuous at that point. Now next definition is when we say that the given function is continuous on given set. Let A be a subset of R and f from A to R be function, then if B is subset of this domain, we say that the function f is continuous, on B. That is, in the previous two definitions we have seen that function is continuous or discontinuous at particular point C. Now here B is subset of A, domain A, then we say that given function is continuous on होल सेट बी वेन एवर ए फंक्शन इज कंटिन्यूअस एट एवरी पॉइंट ऑफ दिस सेट बी. एफ इज सेट टू बी कंटिन्यूअस ऑन बी इफ दैट फंक्शन एफ इज कंटिन्यूअस इफ दैट फंक्शन एफ इज कंटिन्यूअस एट एवरी पॉइंट ऑफ बी. नाउ वी विल सी वन रिमार्क अगेन. फर्स्ट रिमार्क इज द कॉन्स्टेंट फंक्शन इज कंटिन्यूअस ऑन आर. The constant function is continuous on R. That is, the function is given by, suppose C is the element of R, then limit x tends to C of given function f of x is equals to, suppose the given constant function is given by f of x is equals to suppose b for all x belongs to domain, then for c belongs to R, limit x tends to f of c will be b, image of that function. So function f is continuous, that is limit x tends to c f of x is equals to b, so given function is continuous at every point, so the constant function is continuous on R. Also the second remark is identity function. Suppose g of x is equals to x itself, g of x is equals to x itself is continuous on R, continuous on R. Constant function, identity functions are also continuous on whole real line. Now if you take suppose the third function h of x is equals to 1 by x, then this function is continuous except only at 0. Is this function is continuous on suppose set A, and set A is x belongs to R such that x greater than 0, x belongs to R such that x greater than 0. It shows that h of x is continuous at every point except 0, so for every point which is greater than 0. Now we will see some more definitions in the next lecture.